Ever wondered what would happen to tax revenue if the government were to announce a tax cut measure? Perhaps you might already have an answer for this particular question. But before you do answer, I would like to introduce you to an interesting concept in economics. And so, let's start with the video and understand this concept fully. In economics, there's this interesting and yet simple concept that tells you about the relationship between the tax revenue collected and the taxation rate. This relationship is shown in a bell-shaped curve, and it is called the Laffer curve. The story behind this curve is interesting. The general idea of Laffer's curve was first presented on a napkin by an economist named Arthur Laffer in the year 1974, during an afternoon meeting with Ford administration officials Dick Cheney and Donald Rumsfeld. The curve was named Laffer Curve by Jude Weninsky, who was also present in that meeting. The idea of Laffer's curve is not new. In fact, its roots trace back to a book called Mukadima, or The Introduction, written by a 14th century social philosopher Ibn Khaldun. From this book, Laffer quotes an idea that at the beginning of the dynasty, tax rates are low, revenues are high, and when a dynasty is near its end, tax rates are high and revenues are low. Laffer curve is a very simplistic and powerful tool that can help demonstrate how tax is related to the revenue, which can help government decide an optimal tax rate at which an economy can prosper and at the same time its own revenues are at maximum. This optimal rate is somewhere between 0% to 100%. To further explain this concept, we can take a look at this bell-shaped curve. On the x-axis, we have the tax rate, and on the y-axis, we have the tax revenue. At 0% tax rate, it is clear that government takes nothing in taxes, and so its revenue is practically zero. As we proceed by increasing the tax rate, it is seen that the revenue continues to increase to a point where the government earns maximum revenue. However, this peak declines as the tax rates keep increasing, up until a point when there is no revenue earned at all, which just so happens to be at 100% tax rate. But why? The revenue should have been maximum at 100% tax rate, which is quite obvious arithmetically. However, if we look deep into the economic consequences of higher tax rates, especially when it's 100%, the economic incentive to work and invest gets reduced. And so it makes sense as to why there is no revenue earned at 100%. This can be simply explained through an example. Imagine that you work for a company and they pay you a salary. When the tax rates are low, you do not find it worthless to work. In fact, you are perhaps encouraged to earn even more money, save, and invest. Similarly, the government also benefits from this. As more people continue to earn, the taxes they contribute to the revenue also keeps increasing. Therefore, despite the lower tax rate, the government is still able to earn revenue. Until you realize that once the tax rate rises, you pay more taxes, so your incentive to work naturally declines. Imagine a scenario of 100% tax rate, which means that now you earn a salary only to pay entirety of it to the government. Do you think this will ideally motivate you to work? Perhaps not. And so, the government earns no revenue at that level of taxes. Laffer curve is simple, but that does not mean that it is without its own flaws. Firstly, the curve does not exactly look like a bell-shaped curve. In fact, this curve can change and look different from country to country, based on various economic factors and government spending nature. Secondly, tax source is never singular, which means that if the government were to lower taxes for a particular source, then that decision can negatively impact the revenue earned from other tax sources. Laffer curve assumes that there's just one single tax, which is simply not the case. Thirdly, it might look like people would be disincentivized to work when the tax rates are high. However, as I mentioned, that taxes are never singular, and lowering all taxes at once is simply not possible, owing to its possible negative impacts. And hence, people will still continue to work, despite the higher taxes, as it helps them advance in their career. Lastly, businesses will not stop hiring people simply because tax rates are high, as the tax rates are non-uniform and non-singular. Regardless of its flaws and disagreement on its exact shape and what the actual optimal tax rate is, it is still an interesting and yet basic idea on how tax rates ends up influencing behavior and government revenue. With that being said, what do you think about Laffer curve? Does the idea of optimal tax rate make sense to you? Feel free to share your thoughts, and thank you for watching.